Good morning and welcome to the Kentwood's 4th of July Cost of Freedom Tribute. I'm Kathy Batey here with Spirited Presentations, and also with me is Linda Pacic, and we are your co-hosts today for this parade, the Cost of Freedom Tribute. 4th of July, we're kicking off today and starting with a great crowd on the streets.
Oh, absolutely. And you know what? Get ready, viewers, because you're going to be the judge. Judging today, they're going to be judging for the best float. That's going to be absolutely fantastic, won't it, Kathy?
Yes.
The best musical entry. That's going to be exciting. Mm-hmm. Best dressed bicycle. Best antique. Okay. Best businesses and best nonprofit entry. And the best individual dressed up as a famous person. So we might see an Abe Lincoln.
Uncle Sam. Yeah, George Washington.
Absolutely.
And we'll look forward to seeing how creative the city of Kentwood can become.
And so. I know it's very creative from parades past. Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. Yes. So we're here on the 4th of July, and I can't recall how old our nation is today. I guess I should have looked that up. But we're plugging along and doing well. And the 4th of July is a federal holiday that we use to proclaim that our nation is independent of Great Britain. Imagine, that's something hard to imagine.
Especially with our relationship with Great Britain. It's like, you know, basically we're relations.
It is. But it was a committee of five with Thomas Jefferson as its principal author and revised the wording of the Declaration, finally approved on July 4th. Mm-hmm. So I have to love that. Lots of wonderful facts and things to think about. Certainly, primarily, we think about the military on this date and those who sacrificed and continue to serve as this country and keep us safe so that we can do silly things like parades.
Absolutely fun. Creative.
Very fun. Very fun. So there are several comments that different politicians and different dignitaries have stated. One of them, which I love, is from Thomas Paine, who encouraged the American revolutionists back in the day and said, "Those who expect to reap the blessings of freedom must undergo the fatigue of supporting it." So thank you once again to our military who are out there making us very proud, those who have served in the past and those who are currently serving.
Absolutely, absolutely. And we're going to have some fun facts. And one of the questions I have for all the viewers out there is, how many hot dogs do you think Americans are going to eat today?
Wow.
Later on, we're going to give you the answer, but try to add them up in yourself.
Yeah.
By yourself.
I can't even imagine what the city of Kentwood would be eating.
Let alone all 50 states.
For real. For real. Very, very fun. Okay, our man on the street today is Nate Diedrich, who is a community media coordinator for WKTV. He's the man behind the scenes who runs around. Today he's out on the street and he's going to be in the forefront and help us to meet up with some of our wonderful participants for the parade. Hey, Nate.
Hey, Nate.
We see you out there.
Hi, Nate.
Thanks, Kathy and Linda. It's a pleasure to be here in the Kentwood 4th of July Parade. We're going to try to talk to some of the participants and see why they decided to be a part of this. So we're really looking forward to it.
Yeah, and you have water down there, Nate. It is a warm one here in Kentwood on the 4th of July. We're supposed to get to 100 today.
Almost, 96, 100, 100, so. Next 2 days.
That's how it's supposed to be, right?
It is.
Absolutely.
All right, here we go.
Make sure we have all those fluids moving and watermelon going and all of those.
Okay. Also, don't forget, keep your eye for the best float.
Yes.
Yeah, best dressed bicycle, vehicles, and it's so exciting to hear all the sirens. And speaking of sirens, Kathy, why don't you explain what's going on now?
We have the Cutlerville Fire Department down there keeping us safe and warning us to be careful with those fireworks. It is a very dry ground and sparklers can cause disastrous results. So I'm sure the fire departments would just want to send out that warning. We want them to be able to enjoy the fireworks tonight and not having to be called to any residents or business that is having a fire going on as a result of carelessness with those fireworks. So please, please be careful.
Absolutely. It's fun to celebrate, but we have to do it in style, and that is precautions. Mm-hmm.
Do you know, I went on the website for the Cutlerville Fire Department, and I saw all kinds of relevant information that parents should hear, should see and read, and so I'd encourage you to check out the website for the fire departments. because they have some wonderful information there.
Okay, and also the Kentwood Fire Department is up and coming.
Yes.
Okay.
Here we are. And again, thank you, gentlemen, ladies, for serving us, the Kentwood area.
Absolutely. They work hard and long hours so we can be safe.
And, you know, it always seems that the fire departments are such a part of the parades and the activities of the 4th of July.
Absolutely.
It's wonderful to see them out there in a non-emergent situation so they can remind us that they're here and remind us how important their service is.
Absolutely. And also we can give our appreciation by waving to them and just welcoming into the community. So this is wonderful.
You bet.
Wyoming and, I'm sorry, Kentwood and Cutlerville.
Yes, yes. And I was, you know, I was wondering, Linda, if this year, if we should celebrate the 4th of July with water instead of fireworks. You know?
It would be safer, cooler, and I think, you know, we could put some lights on the water, and it would be really pretty.
It would be. It would
be. It'd be fun.
Keep us all hydrated.
Absolutely, Kathy.
And cooled off, so.
So give a wave.
Yep. And an appreciation. You bet. And when you see them rush by, say bless them.
Absolutely.
Get out of their way.
And you're right. It's nice to hear the sirens when they're not on the way to the fire.
Yes. Yeah, the fire chief has been giving a few too many interviews lately from Kentwood concerning the fires in the area.
Right. They said they had just as many complaints this last week than they did the entire month of June last year at this
time.
Wow. Right.
Yeah, and probably inspired by the dry weather and the middle of the night fireworks. People celebrate 24/7, don't they?
Absolutely. Americans, you know, they don't need a whole lot in order to celebrate, you know? It's wonderful.
Yeah, good at that. You know,
hey,
we're going to talk about the hot dogs.
Can I interview you for TV?
Oh, let's go down and see Nate.
Okay? Yep.
And he found someone on the street that we'd like to talk with.
Hey, Nate.
There he is.
And I'm here with a couple of visitors to the 4th of July parade. What's your name?
Wyoming. Crystal.
Okay, and what's your guys' favorite part of coming out and watching this?
Seeing the dancers and the cheerleaders. Yeah, what she basically said.
Are you guys cheerleaders?
No, I'm not.
Okay.
I am.
Okay. So you guys got any plans for later today?
Yeah, going to see the fireworks.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm with her.
Sounds good.
Yeah.
All right. Well, we've got a couple happy watchers here at the 4th of July parade. Back to you guys.
Wonderful.
Okay.
I'm sure there'll be plenty out here. The streets were lined when I was coming in about 8:30. People were lining up in their favorite spot.
Oh, absolutely. The chairs were out. They were, like you said, they have their annual spot, and that's where they were sitting. It's so great to see everyone out here today, and thanks to the girls that told their story of why they're here.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I was waiting for water to be in there somewhere, but it wasn't there. I'm sure before the fireworks, they're going to find some water somewhere. We hope so, anyway.
Okay, do you want to know how many hot dogs we're going to eat? Is that your guess? 150 million hot dogs will be consumed by Americans today.
Wow.
Absolutely phenomenal.
Is that like a trail to the moon and back?
I think so, Kathy. I really think so.
That's incredible.
Yep.
Okay, Nate, what do we have out there on the street?
All right, I'm here with a volunteer for the Kentwood Fire Parade. What's your name?
Jim Skripka.
Okay, and why do you decide to participate and volunteer for an event like this?
I don't remember how the opportunity came up, but we moved here from Minnesota about 5 years ago, and I'd like to be a little more involved with the community. And first time we did it was last year. In fact, we were right at this corner. We enjoy having this corner and being sort of part of the activities.
So we're going to get to know each other.
Yeah.
Excellent. All right, well, have a wonderful 4th of July.
Oh, thank you. You too.
All right, back to you guys.
Thanks, Nate.
Yeah, I love to see the community come out, don't you?
Oh, absolutely.
All the businesses. These occasions are so wonderful for that, saying people, you know what, I'm going to take this corner, and it's going to be my corner, and I'm going to serve the community here. I love that.
And then what's fun after the parades, guess what we're going to do?
Mm-hmm.
Go home and barbecue.
Yes, we are.
Another fact. How many people will be barbecuing in America today?
Wow. That's a good question. I'd say the majority, that's for sure.
74 million people will have a barbecue this afternoon.
Don't you somehow just feel an obligation to barbecue on the 4th of July?
It's not the same if you don't throw a hot dog on the grill. It just doesn't seem like the 4th of July without hamburgers and hot dogs.
Very true. Hey, we have AmVets coming up.
Oh, wonderful.
And that is, they have a float and... Well, I don't see the motorcycles, but they are here as participants with, you know, why don't you explain, Linda, about what the value of the AmVets and what they do? I think it's so wonderful.
Okay, very good. They support the veterans working through the red tape of their beliefs, compensation, education assistance at no charge to the veterans. Mm-hmm. We honor those military men and women who served us and protect us as we enjoy the blessings of being a free nation.
Absolutely.
God bless our veterans and military men and women. And hello to Bob Middleton, who's so active. Yes.
Wonderful. And when you see a military person out there, tell them thank you. That means so much to them, whether it's past or current. Let's honor those vets. They certainly need to be.
Absolutely.
And the support of coming back and being, there's a cool car. It looks like a Camaro. I don't know my cars very well, but I'm thinking it's a Camaro. Very cool.
Yeah, they have a nice float as well. Mm-hmm. Remember, keep tallies on those floats.
Yes.
They're going to have a contest.
And Nate, who do you have on the street for us?
Well, I don't have anybody to talk to, but I was told that there's a 97-year-old veteran there on the AmVets float. So just wanted to thank him for his service and for coming out today. Back to you guys.
How wonderful.
Wonderful, and thank you so much, Nate, for sharing that with us.
And the history he must have seen, World War One. The Korean War, World War II.
Absolutely.
And now, of course, all those after, but wow, that's amazing. I hope make sure he gets those fluids today.
Oh, definitely. Yep, he's sitting there and someone right next to his side. Yeah. Wonderful. Mm-hmm. Remember, look for the best dress, bicycles as well. That's another one.
I'm waiting for the dress up of the individuals of the...
I hope there are some out there. I'm sure there's going to be.
I hope so, too. May need a 2012 version of it, though, so we don't wear those heavy clothes and cloths. So look at that street. How wonderful. Oh, we have a band.
What would a parade be without a band?
Absolutely. Ken Yonker, State Representative Ken Yonker, is there with us. And he is in the 72nd State District House. And this is new, they're shifting it because of redistricting, and that's Gain Township, City of Kentwood, Door Township, Layton Township, Wayland Township, and Wayland City in Allegan County. Ken is a regular member of our, and we'll go down to Mate, and he found someone on the street that we need to cut to.
Okay, I'm here with Judge Bill Kelly. Hello.
Hey, how are you? Happy 4th of July.
Thanks so much. Why'd you come out and be a part of the parade today?
Well, I think it's just great to be a part of the community and the community showing up here for this. It's a great event to celebrate our independence.
Wonderful. Thank you so much.
Okay, great.
All right, back to you guys.
Thanks, Nate.
Thank you. And we certainly need the judge. And he serves in the 62nd the District Court of Kentwood. So appreciate it. Look who we have here, Linda.
Yes, the East Kentwood High School Marching Band. Wow, to come out during your summer vacation on the 4th of July to play in the band. Wow, what dedication to these young people. I'll tell you, it's wonderful.
Don't you have such a respect for the discipline of the marching band, folks? I mean, I remember seeing them in the high school, you know, when it's in the middle of summer and in the winter. I mean, they are just a very brave group of individuals.
And they're very, very good. So we're going to just have a moment so you can hear them. And as usual, or I shouldn't say as usual, but for safety, they have water behind them, which is good. This is a very, very drooling day. It's very hot, very humid. little wind, and those kids are marching, and they really practice hard. It's not for the weak at heart. We have, like you said, respect for them and their families, and we thank them for coming out today and giving us their talents.
Mm-hmm. And you know what's wonderful about the marching band, same true with the track teams, I think, is the families. It's such a family event when they do things, when they march, and true for other sports as well. But there's something about the whole family rallies around these marching bands and supports them, and so, as they should. Work hard.
Absolutely. You're only young once, so you have to make the best of it. And you're right. You know, families are very involved with marching bands. I think it's wonderful.
That must be the family there.
I love to see the flags and the red, white, and blue today. I'll tell you, today is red, white, and blue day.
Mm-hmm. Oh, we have a cheer going down there. There's something. Oh, look. It's a Lowe's truck.
There we go.
That certainly is.
Lowe's Home Improvement, yeah. Serving Kentwood on 28th Street. There's always a need for Lowe's any time of the year.
There is, and many people decide to take their vacation as a home project time.
Yeah,
so.
The honeydew vacation.
Yes, absolutely, absolutely.
The honey, fix the roof, paint the siding. Yeah, yes. Honeydew, right. Clean the siding, yeah.
And now's the time. Now's the time to get your flowers at half off, right? All the flowers go down.
Absolutely.
After the 4th of
yeah.
July. Yeah.
And the families are waving. That's a nice looking float as well with
it
the
is.
Fence and
it
the flag.
Is.
Absolutely.
So that will be one to look for in the competition,
yeah,
right?
It's going to be tough, I think.
Yeah,
these contests are going to be tough. Everything is just fantastic today.
Bright, cheery, lots of kids. Love seeing the kids at parades.
And they enjoy it too.
Mm-hmm.
They have fun. It's something that they'll always remember.
Yeah, and you know, I hope that as a community that we're passing down, you know, when honoring the veterans to our kids, and also standing and putting your hand over your heart for the Pledge of Allegiance, you know, all those things that that we're losing touch with. I hope we start reconnecting with that and teaching our kids. It's very cool to respect.
And going back to the basics.
Yeah, for real. Explore and Grow Learning Center, Kentwood Community Church. There they are. Thank you for being in the community. They have a vision for real people, real love, and real life, serving a diverse community in the name of Christ.
Very nice. There's some motorcycles here too, and people taking pictures of the cars and the motorcycles. BioLife.
Plasma services. Yes, they are. Plasma constitutes 57% of the whole blood, and it aids in different diseases and saves lives and trauma victims and kidney diseases, immune disorders. So consider giving blood or plasma today.
Absolutely. You know, people don't realize this. With just a little sacrifice, you can save a life.
Mm-hmm.
You can save a life today.
And several. Oh, wonderful. Nate's on the street. What are you bringing us, Nate?
Hi, Kathy. Oh. I'm here with?
Megan.
Okay, and you're representing?
BioLife Plasma Services in Kentwood, Michigan.
Can you tell us a little bit about
yeah,
yourself?
Yeah, so if you come in and donate plasma at BioLife, you can get up to $50 a week. We have lots of bonuses going on. We have lots of raffles, plasma TVs, we have Xboxes, tons of gear to be given out for prizes. We're handing out water bottles, candy, frisbees, so we're having a good time.
Great. Thank you so much.
Thanks.
Enjoy the parade. All right,
bye.
Back to you guys.
Hey. Thanks, Nate.
Great. It gives a whole new meaning to the word of plasma TV, doesn't it?
Yes. Oh, look at this.
That is so cool. Can you imagine fighting in uniforms like that?
And this is the Knights of Columbus? Absolutely.
Yeah, in our Kentwood area, Knights of Columbus. They're located at... saying the Pledge of Allegiance.
Wonderful. They must have heard
Thank
your
you.
Suggestion.
They must have. I couldn't stand to put my hand over my heart, though. They're actually out of Wyoming on Clyde Park Avenue, so thanks to our Knights of Columbus group for joining us today.
Absolutely. And I know, they have bingo and dinners and dances and things like that. So.
Great hall to hold activities in.
Mm-hmm. Very much.
I hope it's sunny where you are, and I have a feeling if you're in Kentwood, it is. Oh, look what we have here. not sure why they're sweeping off the car, but that's pretty cool. Gorgeous car. Gorgeous car. A muscle car, as they would say, right?
Mm-hmm. And they're cleaning it because it's the auto wash.
Ah, very cool. Oh, look, there's a smaller version.
52nd Street Auto Wash. And there it is. Look at the little one. And he is leading, actually. There he goes.
I hope he doesn't peel out.
I know. Oh, gosh.
Very neat. Nothing like a clean car.
Especially on the 4th of July.
Yeah. That's a patriotic duty.
And there's a decorated golf cart.
Mm-hmm.
There we go. Home Run Derby. KBL Fields. There we go. Kentwood Baseball League.
Oh, Nate, you want to talk to us on the street, please?
Hey, we're here with?
Aaliyah. Raven.
And what are you guys doing in the parade today?
We're passing out candy. I'm handing out snow cones.
And are you guys part of a baseball team?
Yes.
Wonderful. How's your season going?
Good.
Good? All right, what do you guys got planned for the rest of the day?
Well, after the
Home Run Derby.
Yeah, we're going to do Home Run Derby.
Home Run Derby. All right. Enjoy the parade, you guys. Thanks so much. All right. Bye.
What a day for baseball. Certainly. Mm-hmm. Yeah. What a great day to have a game, right?
Oh, fourth absolutely.
Of July.
Apples. Patriotic.
Yeah, it is. Hot dogs.
All American. I mean, you can't, it doesn't get better than this.
No. Baseball, apple pie, hot dogs, parade. There you go. That sums it up.
I love the way they're decorated.
Nate, how are you joining us today?
All right, I'm here with
Harold Mast. I'm a Preston County Commissioner representing District 12.
Wonderful.
It's a wonderful
we know
day
Harold
to be out.
Well. It's good to see you here.
I've been a supporter of WKTV, done a lot of shows there.
We sure do appreciate it. What's your plans for the rest of the day?
Probably spend a little time with the family at home and then probably the fireworks tonight and hopefully stay cool.
Thanks so much for coming out today.
Yeah.
All right, bye. Back to you guys.
Thank you, Harold. He's also a regular on our Government Matters meeting with the Wyoming Kentwood Chamber of Commerce, so we appreciate him and his input and his service.
Well, I don't know if the viewers can see, but we have bubbles all around the television truck. So the kids on the street there are just having a ball with bubble machines.
How fun.
Mm-hmm.
And I see a Ben Franklin down there. Is that the first one that we've seen? There he is. Hey, Ben.
Fantastic. Oh, absolutely.
Carrying his kite. Isn't it amazing that the words of wisdom that he wrote so long ago, we still quote today.
Today.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm.
A penny saved is a penny earned. I think that was his.
It's good advice, no matter who said it.
Really.
Trucks, more trucks.
Yeah.
I don't know if Nate's going to try to talk to him or is Ben Franklin passed.
He might
be passed.
He may be passed.
I hope you got a shot. I know you got a shot. I hope everybody at home was able to see Ben Franklin.
Yeah, I saw him quickly on the screen here, but I hear a band in the background coming. Either that or it's someone's music coming from there.
There's Revolutionary Wood Removal.
Merle's Towing Services. Boy, they've been known around the community for quite some time.
Yes, in fact, I've called them a few times. My buddies, Merle's.
They do towing and jump starts and vehicle unlocks, and 24 hours a day they're open, 365 days a year. So even on the 4th of July, heaven forbid, you should lock your keys in the car, know who to call.
Merle's has a few vehicles.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, on their website, they have a whole fleet of them. I was amazed how many they had. I hear those songs, Grand Old Flag, playing in the background, maybe from one of the trucks.
Dance academies.
Fun. Are they coming up? Oh.
Seems like we have some dancers.
Oh, look at there. Yes. And that. Nate, who do you have for us down there with Expressions Dance?
Been Hey, Linda and Kathy. I'm here with
Expressionist Dance Academy, Elizabeth.
Sarah.
And what are you guys participating for today?
We are participating in a dance for to have people, more people come to our dance studio and dance with us. Because if you're on a performance team, you like go to places like VIP, recital, festival, and parades, and we go to like Relay for Life.
We do Festival and Grand, Relay for Life. We dance at the Griffins ice hockey games. And basically what we're trying to do is encourage other dancers to dance.
Wonderful. Thank you very much, ladies. Enjoy the parade. Fantastic. All right, back to you.
Wonderful. Life is short. Dance through it. I
absolutely
love that.
Very fun. Oh, now we're hearing a little bit of New Orleans here.
There we are, the Griffins. All right. Welcome for the Griffins. Glad to have them here. Makes you want to sing, doesn't it? I'm not much of a singer, but the Grand Rapids Griffins call Van Andel Arena home since 1996. They are members of the American Hockey League, and they are in their 10th season. But it's hard to think of ice and hockey on a day like today, isn't it?
That might be a good idea.
Yeah.
Makes you feel cooler.
For real. For real.
There they are, Grand Rapids Griffins.
I know a lot of people that follow them so closely. Love the Griffins.
And it's something different, a Griffin.
It is.
Nels Gardner.
Okay.
Patricia Gardner.
Yes. Patricia Gardner, she's a judge who took the bench on January 13th of 1997. So she has been in the family division of circuit court. She was appointed in January 2010. Appreciate her service.
Oh, absolutely.
AYSO soccer. All right. Do you know that they are going to close their registration July 6th? So if you're interested in AYSO soccer, you have 2 days to sign up.
Right, by Friday.
Yes.
Yeah, give them a call. And maybe then they can work something out for you. Yes.
Then they go on a waiting list. So now's the time. Get those kids moving. Love it. Echo Trek Fitness. Now,
this is the one we were talking about earlier today. Mm-hmm. Integrate your workout with nature, which is a really interesting concept there. Group sessions all outdoors in all kinds of weather in a different outdoor location every time.
Yeah, you gotta love that. That's really different. 75 minutes of working out at your own pace. So you decide how fast and furious you wanna go. And what a neat concept.
Outdoors, absolutely. Mm-hmm. Another fire truck, wonderful. Oh, with a Dalmatian on top. Oh. Tradition.
Yes. And certainly an American flag on the back.
And here again is Eco Truck Fitness.
Next we have the Corvette Club.
Oh my, this is very, very dear to our hearts.
Mm-hmm. Corvette Club is has been around the West Michigan area for quite some time, and they are honoring on their website our former mayor of Kentwood, who was Richard Root, and they stated on their website.
Yeah, basically that Richard Root who passed away on June 8th at the age of 68. Big black Corvette in heaven, and keep all of us safe on the road. You are missed by all.
Oh, so true.
And the general purpose of the GVCA is to encourage planned trips, events, and social activities for the Corvette Owners Association. And they do provide regular events and exhibitions for Corvette owners and encourage careful and skillful driving.
Hey, Nate, you going to talk to a Corvette owner down there for us? Ooh,
there's a great big hand on that one.
I don't have anyone to talk to. They're busy driving their vehicles, but I just wanted to say it was a real pleasure to work with Mayor Root while he was with us. He was always out at these community events, connecting with the people, and so we'll miss him. And Yeah, I just wanted to say we thank him so much for what he did for the community. Back to you guys.
Look at all those Corvettes.
There's over 22. I just turned around briefly, and I counted 22, so there's more than 22. And isn't that a tribute?
Mm-hmm.
Very much so.
What a great group. Isn't it amazing the different cultures that we involve ourselves with? You know, like the Corvette Club, and then later we'll have the Mustang Club, and all of those organizations.
And then the vintage cars, and you have all those.
Yes, yeah, for real. And, of course, needless to say, the Harley group. It's its own culture
as
well.
That's very fun.
Yes, it is. They are beautiful cars. I love the old ones. I love the new ones. They can't beat a convertible, can you, when it comes to a Corvette?
No, that's classic, isn't
mm-hmm.
it? There's all colors out here today. All colors, all styles. There's flags.
Yeah, red,
there's
white.
There's design.
Mm-hmm.
That's a nice one, yellow, and looks like fire.
Red, white, blue, different years.
There's like a burgundy. You don't see a burgundy very much, like a cherry black.
You don't. Yeah, and there's a two-tone of red and black.
Mm-hmm.
Very cool. I'm trying to remember. You know, they've been around forever, or my forever anyway. The first time I saw a Corvette was I was a kid, and that's been a while ago. So they have certainly been around a while, different versions.
And they're always loved.
Yeah. Nate, do you find someone to speak with us for us?
Hey, Kathy and Linda, I'm here with someone, and I think she may have been a runner in the race this morning. What are you guys' names?
I was a runner this morning. I made about halfway. It was so hot, and I decided that my body was telling me it was not time to run anymore.
How about you? Were you a runner in the race?
No, I was cheering around from the side.
The support team.
Yep.
Excellent.
Team.
What are your names?
Jen.
Cameron.
And are you guys residents of Kentwood?
Yes.
We are.
Okay.
I've been there for 22 years.
Is this your first year in the race?
This is my first year in the race, but I was in the marching band for 4 years in high school. So.
And in the parade, then?
Yeah.
Wonderful. Great. So do you think you'll run again?
Oh, yeah, definitely. As long as it's not this hot.
All right. Thanks so much, guys.
No problem.
All right, back to you, Linda and Kathy.
Wonderful. You know, she brings up a really important point, to listen to your bodies.
Mm-hmm.
So when you get thirsty, it's actually past the need you have for water. You're going into dehydration, especially on a day like this. So good for you. I'd rather have you strong and healthy and standing instead of finishing a race. So good for you.
Okay, and Cameron, you just keep supporting her. And support for each other is just as important as the participant. Keep supporting her. Good to you.
Very true.
And we're still enjoying the Corvettes, and people on the sidewalk are cheering them on and waving to them and having a great time.
Mm-hmm.
With the breeze, it's not so bad.
Yeah. it helps.
Oh, look at that nice cartwheel. I'm sure that some of the children probably couldn't sleep. They were so excited about being in the parade today.
Yes.
We have Olympics here, the float, very nice.
Oh, yeah, coming up July 27th.
Mm-hmm. In London.
Yes, watching all the qualifying events. Oh,
I know.
My heart started racing. It's so excited for all this.
I know, you're on pins and needles.
Mm-hmm. And then when they go to London, that's when, you know, we're all waving our American flag. And
again.
Yes. Yes.
Oh, this talk about cars. Isn't this wonderful?
Mm-hmm.
That's when life was simple,
yeah.
And it was grand.
True enough. Although, oh, look at here. Love this. Got some action on the street.
East-West Karate, it says.
East-West Karate, good deal.
Wow. That takes a lot of skill and practice.
Mm-hmm. And something physical and discipline of the mind and
mm-hmm.
discipline of the body.
Mm-hmm.
Good deal. Look at those kids. You go, kids.
Absolutely.
I don't want to tick you off, but you just go.
Like I say, it does take a lot of concentration.
Mm-hmm.
And that's good nowadays, especially with so many things. People watch computers. It's so good to do something physical.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you. You can tell by the red faces it's hot. Oh, hey, Nate. Who do you have?
There you go.
All right. I am here with some of the people. Is it karate that you do?
Yes.
Okay. What are your names?
Kelly.
Christy.
Riley.
Brendan.
Blake.
Fantastic. And how do you guys like being in the parade?
Kind of. A lot of walking.
A lot of walking. How about you?
It's awesome.
It's awesome. All right. You guys think you'll do it next year?
Yeah.
Probably.
All right. Cool. Have a great parade. Thanks, guys.
Very, very fun.
Little BMW. Oh, look at this float. Legacy Christian School.
Picture yourself at Legacy. Yes, they are a Kentwood Christian school.
Mm-hmm. And we believe that a legacy is built one student at a time in Christ-centered dynamic education for your children.
And they have lots of kids there to prove it.
Absolutely.
Enrolling now.
Little ones drinking water and waving.
Mm-hmm.
On their scooters out here. And
hey, there's a float with the competition. That was very creative, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm. Very nice.
Oh, the aquatic folks here now.
KPS pools.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, the Kentwood Aquatics Club is a group swim team for boys and girls from age 6 to 14 in the winter season and 6 to 18 in summer. KAC is a nonprofit Kentwood community-based program. The program is organized under the sponsorship of Kentwood Public Schools. Mm-hmm. And the team participates, Kathy, in competitive swim meets with other teams in the West Michigan Swim League.
Wonderful.
Absolutely. Go ahead and join up. Sign up.
Mm. Oh, speaking of 4th of July.
Oh, my goodness. Another staple. Mm. An American dream.
Have to have ice cream.
Ice cream.
I wonder if they have any now. I'm ready.
I don't think it would stay ice cream very long in this heat. By the time we got it up here on the truck, it would be... It'd be soup.
It sure would be. Support. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Let's support those wonderful Kentwood businesses by having an ice cream today.
Yeah, they're located on 52nd Street, owner Dave Harnish, featuring s'mores ice cream. Mm. No fire needed with the s'mores, and handing out coupons for ice cream. So they're out there handing out coupons, and they'd like us to thank Bailey's Grove. Perfect treat for today.
Absolutely is. Oh, here we come with another group of cars, the Mustang Club. Now, this is certainly a car that I think of in my childhood that has transformed over the years, right?
Absolutely. And a minute ago, we saw the Lenger Travel Service, and they were locally owned for 35 years.
Miss them. There's Lillian.
Yeah, wave. They promote vacations from ordinary to exotic, laden with luxury and everything in between. So when preparing to travel, lay out all your clothes and your money, then take half your clothes and twice the money.
Isn't that cute? Yeah, for real.
Okay.
Lillian Vanderveen is one of the owners there, has been for 35 years, and she also is on our Wyoming Kentwood Chamber Board and very involved in the community. So you will see her out and about very frequently. Now the Mustangs. Are we on the Mustangs?
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
we
I hear
sure are.
The engines revving.
Culver's just went past, and now the
Culver's
Mustangs.
Another place for ice cream. Yes, we need to go there, don't we?
Oh, absolutely. And they're known for the flavor of the day. Everything is fresh, and the chocolate is just to die for.
Yeah, they have butter burgers. I've never had a butter burger.
And the best frozen custard.
Yeah, and yesterday's flavor was coconut chocolate almond crunch. So I don't know what today's is, but I bet it's something red, white, and blue.
There you go. Hey, there we go with the Mustangs, your favorite.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we have many favorites, but one of our favorites.
Yeah.
Let's put it that way. And they're all colors and years and vintage and
lots of fun. I love the old ones in the front. Those bring back memories.
I was just going to say that. Reminds us of younger days.
Yes, it does.
And there's convertibles. And
I'm so glad they brought
waving.
Yeah, that car has reinvented itself to come come back on the market.
Absolutely.
Much newer version.
And people really appreciate the old classic cars.
They do.
Older.
Nate, on the street, what have you up for?
All right, I am here with...
Kathy.
Mark.
And what do you guys like about the parade today so far?
The Corvette, the Mustang, and the fire department.
Corvettes.
The Corvettes.
Okay. Is this the first time you guys have been to the parade this day?
Oh, we go every year.
Every year.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
All right. Well, thanks very much for speaking with us.
Okay.
All right. Back to you guys.
Good deal. And here we have some good-looking group of young women. Certainly dressed
new
patriotic.
New expressions.
Okay. Must be a dance group, huh?
Absolutely. Dance twirl, USA. And they have the batons. Wow. That is an art in itself,
mm-hmm.
isn't it, Kathy?
It is. Perform for us a little bit in a little bit. I hear the music.
Sounds fun.
It does.
Makes you want to dance and twirl.
Yeah, it does. there's a tribute to, thank you, Kentwood, St. Mary Magdalene Church.
Which unfortunately and tragically burned 1 hour after the law went into effect for fireworks. The fireworks started on the roof. It landed on the roof and started the fire. So.
It's such a warning to us all.
Mm-hmm. Precaution. Like we said, yeah, be careful. And think of where it might land rather than just, you know, there's two parts of fireworks.
Yes.
Larry's Lawn Service and snow plowing. Oh, just think of snow plowing cools you off.
I can't imagine. Hey, there's a, oh good, I'm glad that this is in the parade because I wanted to be sure and mention it as well. July 25th through the 29th, the Vietnam War Memorial will be at Veterans Park. Do not miss this and take your kids to it as well.
Okay, and the dates again, Kathy?
July 25th through the 29th.
Wonderful.
At the Veterans Park.
Okay, so. See you out there, everyone.
You bet.
Cost of Freedom tribute.
Mm. And the Kentwood has been very involved in raising the funds to get that into the area. It's very special for us to have it, but it's no small feat. They have to get it here, the security to get it here, to be honoring it all the way. And okay, well, it looks like much too soon.
Oh, really? We're just getting started.
I know. This gorgeous parade has come to a day on to an end on a gorgeous parade day. So I'm not sure that made sense, but I think the sun is setting in.
Absolutely. And we'd like to thank all the viewers out there for sharing this day today.
Okay, yeah. Yes, and we want to throw it down to Nate and give him an opportunity to bid us farewell. Happy 4th of July, everyone. God bless America.
Right. Enjoy your hot dogs.
All right, this is Nate signing off. It's been a good day. I'm still standing. I hope you guys are doing all right up there. It's been a wonderful parade, and we'll see you again next year from WKTV.
Great. Thank you, WKTV. I love how you are so involved in the community. Everywhere you go, major events, you're going to see them there, sharing all of the community with you at home. So we are appreciative of them. Thank you to the city of Kentwood. Thank you to all the wonderful kids and families that came to the parade.
Participated, absolutely.
Yes. And Linda, what a joy to be with you.
It was fun with you too, Kathy. Okay, well, you be safe. Remember about the fireworks. Be very cautious and think about it before you light them. Okay?
And so with that, we will bid you a happy 4th of July.
Absolutely.